Hello, this is Chester. This is my report for software design pattern. In this video, I am going to explain to you what is a command design pattern. A command design pattern is a behavioral design pattern. According to the Gang of Four, this pattern encapsulates a request as an object, thereby letting you parameterize clients with different requests, query or log requests, and support undoable operations. This pattern lets you package complex commands into a single object, rather than having to perform the multiple steps needed to execute each command every time. You can create a bunch of ready-to-use command objects, each of which can handle multiple steps internally. Looking into a UML diagram, we have a command interface with a single method execute. This interface will be implemented by an actual command. The actual command will require a variable of receiver class in its constructor. The receiver class will have the actual methods of instructions, which will be called in the execute method of the command class. We also have the caller class, which is our invoker class. The caller class will be the one to call the execute method on the command class. The actual code in PHP. So we have here the interface command, which will be implemented by the actual command, forward command, the pause command, the reset command, the start command, and the stop command. So the actual command will receive a receiver class. The receiver class will actually have the actual code instruction. So in this case, it will just save a message and what actual command it performed. So it will just write to our database. So when we say forward, in the execute method, we have here the connect method, which actually connect to our database, then it will set the command variable to forward, and we'll set a message to this is forward command, and the date and time will actually perform the write command, which is will save the messages to our database, and then the disconnect method, which will disconnect to our database. And so we also have here our invoker, the caller class. The caller class will actually house what actual command it will run. So and then it will call the execute method. So this is a receiver class. So to test our code, I have here the test. So it's actually called the classes. So I have here, so I prepared the interface ready. So we have here 5 buttons: the stop, the start, the stop, the pause, forward, and the reset. So once the command is being performed, so it will capture what type of command, then it will set the caller, what type of command, then we'll called the run method. So I have here, so let's test this code. Here we call test. So once we click the start button, so it will display the output here. So what type of command start, and what type of what message. So this is a start. We click the stop. What? The reset will actually reset the whole database. Okay. And that is the command design pattern.